The government has brought new acts to replace the old and the archaic acts to remove the irregularities and corrupt practices in the administration. The reforms are being implemented to ensure that they totally remove any possibility of corruption and delay, as well as offering total transparent services to the people. The new Panchayat Raj Act, the new Municipalities Act, and the new Revenue Act have brought a sea changes in the state administrative setup. The new acts have brought into achieve and fixed targets. The officials, public representatives, and people have now got clarity on their duties and responsibilities. The development works are taking place in both urban and rural areas without any confusion and obstacles. Dharani portal, a revolutionary reform. Earlier, there used to be a utter confusion and lack of clarity on the land ownership rights. Hence, the government decided to change the scenario. The government in the first phase had taken up the comprehensive land records rectification and publication program. About 95% of land records were given clarity on the ownership rights. Based on this, new passbooks were issued. This is the reason why nearly 60 lakh farmers in the state are getting the right to bandhu assistance without any problem. The new Revenue Act had brought a revolutionary changes in the land administrations. The government had launched the Dharani portal with complete information on the agriculture land in the state. Dharani portal ensures abundant transparency with regard to land records. The farmer-friendly Dharani portal has been a path-breaking initiative in land records management. It removed discretion of officials, simplified processes, eliminated corruption, and has brought in transparency. Anyone from anywhere in the world can access the details of this land through Dharani portal. The government had also brought in great reforms in the registration system based on Dharani to ensure easy, smooth, and transparent method of selling, purchasing, and alienation of the agriculture lands. The farmer are able to complete the process of registration and mutation within minutes without seeking anyone's help, without running around pillar to post, and with no scope for corruption or delay. The farmers are able to finish the process in their own mandals. They get their passbooks speedily. Being testimony to its popularity, in less than 5 months from the date of its launch, more than 3.29 lakh transactions, including 1.06 lakh pending claims for mutation of records, have been completed using Dharani. People are happy that Dharani portal and the new registration process have been successful 10%. It is a moment of joy that the reforms brought in after 3 years of brainstorming have been yielding good results. The government has also decided to take up digital survey of all the states to remove any litigation with regards to the land boundaries. Based on this survey, boundaries will be fixed with proper coordinates, latitude and longitudes, which no one can ever tamper with. Not only disputes of boundaries of the farmer lands, but also that of government and forest lands, government and non-government lands, endowment lands, wakf lands, etc., would also be solved. They would have their boundaries fixed to put a stop to the litigation. If there is a clarity regarding the issues of land, there will be an increase in 3 to 4% of GDP growth rate. This is an experience from other countries. If there were an absolute clarity on land administration, proper and transparent registration process in Telangana state, it would lead to peace in the villages and would definitely help development of the state. Quality education to the poor, students, and in residential educational institutions. The state government has started large number of residential institutions to impart quality education to the students from the poor and to lay the foundation for their bright future. There were only 298 residential schools when the state was formed, and they were also run with paltry facilities. The Telangana government newly started 619 residential schools and 53 residential degree colleges, for the SC, ST and BC and minorities. Now in the state, in 970 residential educational institutions, 4,29,686 students are given quality education on par with the international and corporate standards. It is a matter of gratification for the government that students from these institutions are faring exceedingly well in several tough competitive examinations in the country, international games and sports. Best public health care. The development and welfare programs launched by the government for increasing the living standards will have a purpose only if people have healthy, people live healthy. Hence, the government is giving top priority to the medical and health sector. To offer better medical services to the people, the government had increased facilities in the government by leaps and bounds. The bed number is increased from 17,000 to 23,450. At the time of formation of the state, there were only 254 beds with oxygen facility, whereas now it has been increased to 11,758. While there were only 100 beds with ventilator facility, now there are 1,484 beds. The strength of dialysis centers have been increased from 3 to 49, ICUs from 4 to 29, sick newborn care units from 18 to 42, blood banks from 18 to 31. The government is maintaining 3 kidney transplant centers, 2 liver transplant centers, 2 heart transplant centers, 22 virology labs, and had set up 25 diagnostic centers. For the first time, the government is operating 300 Amma OD vehicles to transport pregnant women to the hospitals and to bring them back home, and 50 Parampada vehicles to bring bodies of those dead in the hospitals to their homes with dignity. The results obtained due to the betterment of the public health are evident. In the past, the infant mortality rate was 39 out of 1,000 births, and now it has come down to 26. In the past, there were 92 deaths of pregnant women at the time of deliveries among 1 lakh. Now it is reduced to 63. There is 10% increase in the inpatient strength and institutional deliveries in the government hospitals. Under the KCR kit program, the government is giving rupees 12,000 to each pregnant woman and rupees 4,000 worth kits to reduce the risk of mortality of women and child, so as to compensate the woman for the wages she lost at the time of pregnancy and postnatal period. The government has started 4 new medical colleges to create medical education opportunities. MBBS seats in the state are increased from 850 to 1,640 and PG seats from 531 to 835. Development of roads. Better connectivity leads to better society. The government has implemented a comprehensive policy to improve the road network in the state. A policy decision is taken that the 4-lane roads are laid from district headquarters to the state capital, 2-lane roads from mandal centers to district headquarters, and roads to every village. This policy is being implemented strictly, and the change is evident. And earlier, at the time of formation, only 669 kilometers 4-lane roads were there, whereas now they are increased to 1,029 kilometers. Double lane roads length is increased from 6,093 kilometers to 13,273 kilometers now. This resulted in the reduction of single lane roads from 17,483 kilometers to 13,785 kilometers. Bridges numbers also increased from 2,893 to 3,323. Panchayat Raj roads length also increased from 64,044 kilometers to 69,844 kilometers. Dream of regional ring road realized. The government has proposed regional ring road to decongest traffic in Hyderabad and provide better transportation facility among the districts. I am happy to announce that the state government, with lot of effort, got the center's nod for the regional ring road via Sangareddy Narsapur, Tupran, Chaupal and Shadnagar in a circular way. 30 kilometers away from the outer ring road, 348 kilometers long ring road would be formed like another necklace to the Hyderabad city. I am sharing the information that the government is very keen and committed to complete the land acquisition and start works on the regional ring road as early as possible. Harita Telangana. Trees are lifeline for the living beings. For a peaceful life, greenery should be present in the right proportions. By the time of formation of Telangana state, forests were on the verge of extinction. Forest lands were grabbed. There is no green cover in urban and rural areas. The government is organizing Telangana Ku Harida Haram program aimed at reviving the forest and increase green cover to 33% and is being done with lot of prestige. With stringent measures, cutting the forest is stopped. Top priority is given to raise forest in the forest lands. Plant nurseries are set up everywhere to enable people to get the saplings of their choice. A condition is imposed that the village panchayats and the municipality should allocate and spend 10% of their funds on greenery. This resulted in increase of green cover in the villages, towns, along the roadways and in the open spaces. There is awareness among all individuals on protecting and growing plants. The Forest Survey of India, an organization of Government of India, in its report stated that in Telangana state, there is 3.67% increase in the green cover since formation of the state. This is a success of the Harita Haram program. Government of India has also announced that Telangana state is in forefront and on top in the entire country in tree plantation and on a large scale and in increasing green cover of the state. Effective maintenance of law and order problem. Progress and development flourish when law and order prevail in the society. This is the reason why the Telangana government accords the highest priority to the maintenance of law and order situation. There is a huge increase in the allocation of funds in budget for the police department. The police department is given the required staff, vehicles and technology tools in large numbers. There were 63,181 posts in the police department at the time of formation of the state, whereas it is now increased to 86,829. Vehicles are increased from 5,703 to 20,004. Every vehicle is equipped with latest technology. With increase in vehicles, the police are now able to reach the crime spot within 10 minutes on receiving the message. The Telangana police are not just limited themselves in discharging their police duties, but are also forming part of several social responsibilities. The police did a wonderful job in eradicating the illicit liquor trade. Closing down the playing card clubs and curtailing the sale of spurious goods. The police did an immense job during the corona pandemic, have lived up the definition of people's friendly police in the state. The state had set a record in the country by installing 6.65 lakh CCTV cameras, which account for 65% of the total CCTVs installed in the entire country as a part of surveillance and detections at all the open areas. Britain-based Comparitech organization stated that the Hyderabad city occupied the 16th position in the world among the cities that are causing CCTV cameras. Cyber warriors are posted in every police station to tackle cyber crimes and also educate people about the cyber-based crimes. This is the first time in the country that the special officers are posted exclusively to detect cyber crimes in all the police stations. The command and control content set up on the international standards with the state of art of technology in Hyderabad would make operational shortly to maintain and monitor law and order situation as well as several celebrations, jatara and meetings. Industries, IT. It is essential to expand manufacturing and service sector to develop the state economically and create employment opportunities. Hence, the government in implementing innovative and model policies to encourage investments in the field of manufacturing and IT sectors. favorable climate, a 24-hour quality power supply, better law and order situation have created a congenial atmosphere in the Telangana state for business, trade and industrial activities. The IPA system won laurels in all the assured in the revolutionary changes in the industry sector. In ease of doing business, Telangana state stands among the top three states. World famous companies are operating their offices in Hyderabad due to simple, speedy and transparent clearances. Under Telangana State IPA Act, as on date, 15,252 units have got the permissions and clearances. The investments through them are to a tune to over 2.13 lakh crores. These industries would create employment opportunities to over 15.51 lakhs of individuals. IT sector is making rapid strides in Telangana state. Internationally renowned IT companies are opening database centers in Hyderabad. The IT hub managed by the state government has become base for many startup companies. After formation of Telangana state, newly 250 IT companies came to the state and 5,82,126 employees are working in them. In the first year of state's formation, the IT exports were 66,276 rupees crore. By 2019-20 financial year, they are more than doubled and now stand at 1,28,877 crore. In the IT export growth rate, the national average is 8.09%, while Telangana's growth rate is 17.93%. It is crystal clear that Telangana state, even in adverse conditions, is achieving progress. The proof is reflected in the announcement of National Association of Software and Services Companies that the IT exports in the state may reach to 1.40 lakh crores in the 2020-21 financial year despite the corona effect. I proudly announce that Telangana state is in forefront in providing digital services to the people. An indication of the state's participation in the Digital India program is that in large scale e-transactions by the people of the state. In the Innovation Index published by Niti Aayog for 2020, the Telangana state stood in the fourth place. This is a result of the government bringing in several innovations in various sectors. Hyderabad as a global city. Hyderabad belongs to everyone. With people coming and staying here from all over the country, it has become a true cosmopolitan city. People from different regions, religions, creeds and community are living happily together here. Hyderabad is becoming a global city by increasing its infrastructure facilities, maintaining the low pollution levels, proper law and order situations, smooth flow of the traffic and so on at international standards. So far, 18 major projects are completed as part of strategic road development program to make Hyderabad a signal-free city. Of this, 9 flyovers, 4 underpasses are constructed and the cable bridge at Durgam Lake has become a tourist attraction and also a good drive way for the Hyderabadis. My government has started Basti Davakanas in the city, in the areas where poor live and provided better Medicare facilities near their localities. 225 such Basti Davakanas which have been set up for giving better medical facilities for the poor are working well by providing excellent medical care services. In the Basti Davakanas, teleconsultation, lab tests, medicines and immunizations are provided free of cost. As per of Swachh Hyderabad program to avoid open defecation and urination, nearly 4,225 public toilets are set up in addition to the existing ones. In recognition to the Green Cover Program of Hyderabad, Arbor Day Foundation of Food and Agriculture Organization of the UN has certified Hyderabad as Tree City of the World for 2020. The whole world is looking at Hyderabad with lot of interest. India Skills 2021 report stated that several higher learning, highly educated and highly skilled professionals in the country are planning to settle down in Hyderabad in various jobs and professionals. This report jointly prepared by VBOX, Confederation of India, of Indian Industry, CII, the TAG Foundation has once again showcased Hyderabad to the world. The JLL report stated that Hyderabad stood first in the office space occupancy. Rate growth in the country. The same organization has declared Hyderabad as the most livable city in the country. Hyderabad is also famous for pharma city, famous as a pharma city. The Hyderabad-based pharma companies have created vaccines, drugs and medicines for several dreaded diseases that made human beings suffer a lot. It is a proud moment for all of us that the Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech Company's co-vaccine for COVID was approved and recognized. The government is setting up pharma city on the outskirts of Hyderabad to develop and expand the pharma sector. Earlier, Hyderabad used to be under regular curfew orders. After formation of the Telangana state, curfew was not imposed even for a day in the city. This also shows how peaceful the city has been. Communal harmony. Telangana is known for the communal harmony and peaceful coexistence. This state has the distinctive and unique Ganga Jamuna Tehzeeb. The government respects all religions equally. Hyderabad makes everyone who comes to her fold comfortable and happy, no matter where they come from. This is the reason everyone proudly proclaims himself, herself as Hyderabadi. I am making amply clear that the state government would protect communal harmony and peaceful coexistence of the people. Nowhere in India, we can say, now here in India also we can say. The Telangana state government has shown and proved its mettle by formulating several innovative and revolutionary schemes and programs for the welfare and development which are unheard in the city, in the country so far. I am mentioning here few of such programs and schemes aimed at providing better services to the people. These innovative and one of its kind program are not being implemented anywhere in the country, and they are exclusive for Telangana state only. Take for instance the agriculture sector, Raitu Bandhu crop loan assistance, Raitu Bima, abolition of water cess, Raitu Bandhu samitis, 24-hour quality power to the pump sets, reservations in market committees, one agriculture extension officer for every 5,000 acres, construction of 2,601 Raitu Vedikas for farmer interactions, free regulation of Sada Bainamas, updating and rectification of the land records. These are all unique to these state only. In the welfare sector, Kalyan Lakshmi, Shadi Mubarak pensions for single women, pension for BD workers, pension for people suffering with filaria, monthly allowances for imams, mausams, accidental insurance for journalists, home guards, construction labor, drivers, etc. Mission Bhagiratha scheme. Telangana is the only state government which is providing safe and pure drinking water through pipes and taps to every household. This is the only government which constructed MLA offices. The only government that is providing meal to the hostel students cooked with fine rice. Telangana is the only state where mobile clinics for animals are arranged and vehicles for carrying dead bodies known as Parampada are made available. The only state which recognized Kanti Velugu program and conducted eye tests for its citizens. Telangana is the only state government which abolished transport tax for autos and tractors, and only government that is providing pollution allowance to the traffic police and risk allowance to the security wing for police. This is the only state where illicit liquor sale and consumption is totally eradicated and closed down all the playing card clubs. This is the only state which banned gambling. The only state that is protecting women with formation of their she teams, and the only state which is setting a police command control center with international standards. This is the only state government which provided free registration facility to the poor through GO number 58. The list is endless, and these are all proof of the state's vision and its visionary leadership. State then and now. The Telangana, which in the past was ridden with starvation, deaths and suicides, is now shining with hope, glory and happiness. The agriculture sector, which was regarded as a wasteful profession, is now a profitable vocation with lot of prosperity and festivity. The irrigation projects, which were confined to the paper, have now become a reality and providing the much needed water for cultivation. The arid lands then are now turned into irrigation lands. The state came out of darkness and is now marching towards becoming a power surplus state. The region, which was thirsting for a drop of drinking water, is now getting pure and safe drinking water through pipes and taps every day to every household. The people who lost their faith in the government hospitals have now regained their faith and confidence in government hospitals. Continuous efforts are put in for a healthy Telangana. The quality education, which was not within the reach of poor, is now available to them without spending even a paisa. The hostel students are enjoying their meal with fine rice and are happily pursuing their studies. With the government itself coming forward to help the poor families in performing their daughter's marriage, there is happiness, joy and satisfaction among those families with girl child is born, when a girl child is born. In the past, the public sector undertakings were put up for auction, whereas now the PSUs are getting strengthened all by themselves and help and support from the state government. The roadways, which were called the roads to hell, are now safe to travel and are known for the comfortable drive. The field level staff who used to get meager wages are now getting reasonably good, respectable salaries and leading their lives with dignity and comfort. The gram panchayats and municipalities, which used to starve for funds, are now getting funds every month without fail. Then eggs, vegetables, fish, mutton, fruits, milk were imported from other states, whereas now the Telangana state have come to a stage whereas it is on the verge of exporting them. Then the district headquarters were located at a long distance and now they are within the reach of common man. Then industries were closed on regular intervals, while now more and more industries are coming to the state. Then curfews were order of the day. Now there is total peace and harmony everywhere. This is the difference between the Telangana then and Telangana now. Rededication in the service of the people. This is the amazing development growth achieved by my government. My government is striving forward with mammoth confidence by overcoming the anti-progressive elements who intend to create obstacles to this development. Telangana is the only state in the entire country which is implementing innovative schemes in many sectors. It stood at the top place among the progressive states in the entire country in distributing the fruits of progress to all sections of people. These are not my words, but central government has announced this on many instances through many reports. This matter is being acknowledged by many national and international organizations of repute. This development and welfare yagna will continue, and many more steps will be taken with humanitarian perspective so that the fruits of progress will reach all the downtrodden sections in the society on priority basis. I hereby inform one and all that my government is rededicating itself to achieve this objective. I would like to conclude with a couplet from the immortal Thirukkural of the legendary Saint Thiruvalluvar, which truly reflects the present state of Telangana. Perumporulal, Pettagadagi, Arunketal, Atra Vilaivadu Nadu, which means a state which has abundant wealth, absence of calamity, and never failing harvest make a good state. Jai Hind, Jai Telangana.